Hi and welcome, students. This video will cover Microsoft Access 2016. I'm going to show you the backstage view when you open up Microsoft Access, as well as the window itself once you actually start your database. Let's go ahead and get started. So the first thing that you'll see here is what's called the backstage view. And the backstage view always has your recent documents, or in this case your recent databases, over here on the left side. And open other files menu. So if you have a database maybe that you haven't opened up in a while and you don't see it on this list, you're going to see it over here where you open other files from either a hard drive or a USB or even your OneDrive account or cloud storage. And then over here on the right side, you're going to see a blank desktop database, which is going to be most of your starting points. So I'm going to start here with blank desktop database, and then if you have any other featured templates, they'll be listed below here. So Access is a little bit different from other Microsoft Office programs because you actually name it and choose a location first rather than opening it up first and then eventually saving it to a location. So here I'll just call it example, and it's going to be saved to my C drive, and that's the file pathway that's displayed. So I say, all right, perfect, let's create it. And so you'll see that it opens up a table by default. And if this is your first time checking out Microsoft Access, it can be pretty intimidating. So I'm going to try to make this as easy to understand as possible in terms of what the ribbon looks like and what you're kind of seeing in front of you. So let's get started with that. So up here at the top, you're going to notice that this is the quick access area, kind of like a quick access toolbar. You have your save option, and then you also have undo and redo options. I never use this area, so I don't worry about it too much. Over here in the middle, you're going to see your the name of your database and the file pathway, and then you have minimize, maximize, and close. All right. Below all that, that's when we get started with the ribbon. Okay, the ribbon is all over Microsoft Office, whether you're using Word, Excel, Access, PowerPoint, Outlook. It all has the same kind of user interface as far as choosing different commands. And so the first thing that you're going to notice is the file button, or in this case it's called a tab, okay, the file tab. When you click on that, it's going to take you into the kind of like another backstage menu where you were looking at before, and this is where you could save your database or go to save as to choose a different name or location, where you can print out reports or forms or tables or anything else, your account settings for updating Access, and then your advanced options down here. You could also check out how to create a new database and open a database from in here. Okay, this is also one area where you can close Access. So lots of options in here, but these options do not really affect your actual database too much in terms of you know, like records of content and things like that. So this is mostly for saving, closing, and your account options. Alright, so going back, you click this little arrow. This up here is the file tab, as I mentioned. Right next to it's the home tab. Next to that is create, external data, database tools, and then this over here is kind of a conditional tab for tables, when tables is open, so or when a table is open. So basically these are your tabs up top. Okay, within each tab you will have what's called a group, and the groups are right below here. You have your views group, clipboard, sort and filter, records, find, and text formatting. So each tab contains its own set of groups. Now the reason that these groups are here is because when I'm teaching you how to use Microsoft Access, I'm never going to say to you, go to the home tab and click bold. Okay, because what's going to end up happening is you're going to have to go, okay, bold, bold, bold. And you're going to look through all these buttons before you eventually get over here to bold. Instead, what I'll say is go to the home tab, go to the text formatting group, so then your eyes go over here automatically. You only have to just read up to that point, and then you go to bold. Okay, so that's how the user interface for Microsoft Access works, and that's how I will teach you about navigating around this program. I'm never going to tell you, hey, create a new form. I'm going to say, hey, go to the create tab, and within here, go to the forms group and click form. right? So that's how to navigate around Microsoft Access in terms of the buttons, okay? So you'll see all these different tabs and groups and buttons up at the top. Now the thing is the Home tab is typically used for sorting and filtering and text options, okay? So that's what this area is going to be used for. Create is where you create tables and queries and forms and reports. So this is where you're going to create most of the different objects in Access. External data is whenever you want to either send your current database to an external place, which would be an export to something else, or you want to bring data from maybe Microsoft Excel into Access, and so that would be an import. So that's what external data does. Usually that you're only going to be in this tab for a very specific purpose, whether it's importing or exporting. And then you have your database tools. Database tools contains things like macros and creating table relationships. I do have some videos on that in my playlist, and I'll explain those in better detail once those show up. Okay, I'm going to skip these last two fields for now, or these last two tabs for now. Below the ribbon, okay, once you get below the ribbon, you're going to see right over here, these are your All Access objects. So these are going to be all of the objects that you currently have in your database. Objects could be things that are objects are things that you typically create in this Create tab. So you're going to see tables, you're going to see queries, forms, reports. Okay. Over here we have one table by default. It's called Table 1. That's what we see over here on the right side. So whichever object is listed on the left side, you can open and close that object. You'll see here, this is called Table 1, and it is open right now. I could close this table by clicking this little X right over here, and now it's closed. Okay, and so you'll see it didn't even bother saving that object because we never even adjusted anything on it. So it just looks like an empty database right now. So let's say that I wanted to create a table. I'm in this Create tab. I create a table, and you'll see that Table 1 is now created. Within these tables, I'm going to show you on this data or on this playlist on YouTube how to create tables, how to edit them, how to go into create and edit queries, and how to create and edit forms and reports. So I'm not going to get into that in this video as far as what's going on this table, because I explain it in other videos. But that's what this is when you start looking at Microsoft Access for the first time. It's just a blank table that's listed here. So hopefully this video hasn't scared you off of Access. It's really not that complicated of a program. I'm going to do my best to teach it to you throughout the rest of this playlist if you're watching it. And so I'm going to constantly be adding videos to it. So if you guys learned something in this video, please give it a thumbs up. Consider subscribing to the channel. I have lots of Access videos coming out over the next couple weeks, as well as well into the future. So thank you so much for watching. And if you have any questions or comments, please put it in the comment section below, and have a good rest of your day.